Ladies and gentlemen, what is happening? Welcome to Talking Guitars and More. We're at episode 16. We'll be right back after this brief introduction. Don't go anywhere. Stick around. We got a great show planned for you. I'm using a different angle here, so hopefully that works. All right. We'll be right with you. Hang on. Saturday evening, man. What is the 30th? What is the day? Yeah, the 30th. Man, this month is about gone. March the 30th. Here we are, man. 9:01 Eastern Standard Time. Welcome to another episode of Talking Guitars and More. We're live on YouTube and Facebook as well. That's pretty much the only two platforms that I pretty much use to stream on or whatever. but yeah, man, having a good time. Played some guitar this weekend. I stayed up late last night playing. Played a few hours, I guess. You ever play so much, man, your fingertips just get so tender. You're like, ugh, I can't play no more. All right, let's bring in the panel. We got a great panel again this evening. And here we are to the stage, Mr. Jimmy Biter. There he is, ladies and gentlemen. All right. He's back again. Yay. Cool deal, man.
Probably too much chagrin of some watchers.
No, man. We love having you here, man.
I just like being the class clown.
I love it, man. Up to bat next is Mr. Andrew Knox, ladies and gentlemen. There he is, the man from the South.
Andrew. How about it, everybody? How y'all doing?
Yeah, thank you, Andrew, for taking the time to be here.
Joe, my PayPal hasn't gone through yet.
Uh-oh, I need to check that. Let me see. Yeah,
I mean, I got things to do, you know.
I got things to do. It's on hold. Oh, man.
And, unverified.
Unverified. The tech man himself, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Larry Riker is here. There he is.
Hey, what's up, everybody?
Larry.
What's up?
What's happening, man?
I'm excited, man. 16th show. Wow.
I know. This is great. Also, to the stage, my son Nathan is here. Hey, there he is. What's up, son?
How you doing?
Nathan. Thank you for that. I tried to fix where I got an applause, but it's over on the other side. Golly, I'm using a different mixer, a different setup, so that effect is not accessible right now. Oh man, so let's go around the board real quick and we'll check the chat in just a few minutes. Let's go to Mr. Jimmy Biter, man. How was your past couple of weeks, sir?
Well, been fighting snow the whole time.
Oh man. Oh wow.
It's spring in the valley and it decided to finally be winter up on the mountain. So got about 2 feet of snow this week. And what was it, Thursday? We had a whiteout blizzard that lasted for about 3 hours and spent about 3 hours in the skid steer with the snowblower on it, and then once that was over, I had to get back out in it and open the road back up.
Dude, I love that shirt.
I was going to say the same thing.
That is so funny.
I love that shirt. All right, let's move over to Mr. Andrew Knox, man. He hasn't been on in a while, but hey, he's back, ladies and gentlemen. There he is. Andrew, how's things been going for you, brother?
It's been going good. I got quite the opposite here as far as weather from Jimmy. It has been mid-70s, low 80s. It's Florida, man. Just doing the Florida thing.
Nice, man. Nice.
And
nice,
I have a nice shirt on, too.
I saw that. I was going to comment on that. I like that. That looks
Jimmy
cool,
Biter,
man.
Jimmy Biter fan, R2 fan, Ryan fan, John fan.
Yeah, absolutely.
Randy fan, everybody fan.
Yeah, Trev, all of them. Very cool. Let me get over here to Mr. Larry Riker. How are you doing, Mr. Riker? How was your past couple of weeks, my friend?
Oh, it's been fantastic. I can't complain. Getting outside a little bit. You know, it's getting warm. Spring. Got some
feels
sun.
So nice. Oh man, I like your shirt too, man. That's awesome.
Yeah, this is for. I got this. This is Ralph, the German butcher, likes this.
Yes, he loves his Jackson shirts, man.
So, yeah, maybe I'll be getting one soon.
Yeah, there you go. Hey, that'd be great to show. All right, yep. That'd be awesome. Let's move over to Nathaniel. What's going on, son? He was just over here a while ago. Him and his wife, and we had our Easter dinner tonight because I got to go to work tomorrow. So, how you been the past couple of weeks, my man?
Oh, you know, just life, work, trying to keep up with everything. You know how it goes.
Yeah, yeah. Believe me, don't I ever. I'll be right back in it tomorrow. So, yeah, this weekend has went by so fast. Mm. Oh, my God. Let's jump in the chat real quick and thank the people who are here currently with us. And let me go up here. We got, first up, Mr. R2, R3 locking. There he is. What's up, R2?
R2.
What's up,
R2.
Man? Hope you're doing well, sir. Gear Up Guitar, which is Larry's new brand. I think he changed, not his brand, but his new channel name. Is that right, Larry?
Yeah.
Correct? I about said Gary. Who the hell am I talking about? All right.
Yep.
That's nice, man. Okay.
Sweet. Dig that.
Of course,
the
Mr. Knox in there. And R2
Get
says
him out.
Hello to everybody.
Oh,
get him out.
That's crazy, man. Let's see here. Mr. Jim Guidry, he says, happy Saturday, everyone. Jim just released a video on his channel. It's called Seasons. Check it out. He's got an instrumental up there. He let me listen to it a while ago. I was lucky, man. He let me hear that as it was in development. And I love it. I think it sounds amazing. And it's different from what he usually does, but I really enjoy it. It's really nice. It's laid back. Cool. I really enjoy it.
Cool.
So check out Jim Guidry on YouTube, y'all. Check out his new video.
Got the same
Show the guys
initials.
Some love, man. Mm-hmm. Show him some love, man. All right. Mr. Fletcher Floyd, what is going on, my friend? Thank you for being here. He says, what's up, folks? Hope y'all are having a killer weekend. Yes, sir.
What's up?
So far, so good. Yeah. Blue Mox is in there. What's going on, Mr. Blue Mox? How are you
y'all give
doing,
him a sub, too. I heard about him on Ryan's OU812 channel. He's starting to stream his own stuff. Hopefully I'll get there one day. I'm working on getting to that point, but he's already on it, up and running.
Blue Mox, that's awesome, man. I need to check him out and give him a sub too. I need to check that out. Yeah, man, absolutely. Let's see. Mr. Mike G is in the chat. He says, hi, y'all. What's going on? How are you doing?
Mike.
Johnny Bean in the chat. What's up, Johnny? He says, hey, dudes. What's up, Johnny? How are you doing? There's Ralph, the German butcher.
Ralph.
That's my Charvel behind Jimmy.
I see it.
Oh, my goodness. There's Mr. Ryan from OU812. What's going on, Ryan?
Hey, Ryan.
How you doing, brother, man?
Hey, now.
I like your live video this morning from Guitar Center. I was watching that. That was cool. Jimmy, you see what Ron says?
I'm a whore.
Oh my goodness.
Just support single musicians. Like you should. Yeah. Just a musician.
Oh my goodness, that's funny. Jeff K, what is going on, man? Thank you for being here. Really appreciate it so much. Really appreciate that. My pleasure, Mr. Guidry. Yeah, man, my pleasure. Oh man, chat's going moving, boy. Thank y'all so much. Love the OU crew shirt. Ron says, yeah, man, I ordered a hat from Ron's channel, and so it should be here. It's a holiday, so it'd probably be here. I'm going to guess and say probably the end of next week, maybe.
I think I got my shirt in like 3 days. It was ridiculous. But I know they all come from like different places. But
yeah, they have different warehouses, I think. But yeah, they're usually pretty good. Jeff says, "Hey Ron, great safari today and post studio." Yeah, man, awesome deal.
I was wondering, cool. did anybody buy anything? I saw Randy.
Yeah, did y'all buy anything, Ron? Or y'all just taking a gander? Y'all both are playing some killer stuff. Randy was throwing down, boy. I was like, God dang, man. Jim says, hey, Ryan. And Ryan responds, says, hey, Jim, how are you? Yeah, that was cool, man. I love to see some cool guitars and cool guitar playing and all that good stuff. It's a lot of fun. Hopefully the German Butcher and I can get back to another guitar center and do a video. Our schedules are just so... off center. Oh, they did buy something. Ryan says, OU812 channel. Yep. Brought home a Freeman Cali.
Oh, bought the Cali. It doesn't have a deck trim.
Wow.
Wow.
Very nice. Congratulations. That is awesome, man. Very cool indeed. Dang. Yeah, how can you go get to Guitar Center and not buy something? It's difficult for me. I know that. Oh my God.
I don't know what you're talking about, Joe.
Yeah, I don't either. I need to shut up. I don't know when. Is it April? April Fools. Anyway, so speaking of playing guitars and stuff, Andrew was talking about a plug-in earlier, and I would like him to talk about that a little bit for people who are interested in maybe playing live on the internet and stuff, because I remember when I first started to tinker around with that years ago. I mean, they've come a long way now to help musicians, you know, to get a good sound direct over the internet. And there's a lot of different things you can choose from. You can go from the Rodecaster Pro 2, like what Jimmy uses, and Ryan and other people on that channel. And you can go to straight out of a Headrush into a mixer. That's what I'm doing. And then, but Andrew has found another way that I thought was very interesting. So, Andrew, I'll let you take it from here, sir. There you go.
All right, so what started it all off? I have a Headrush Prime too, currently, and I was wanting to do like Joe does and play through or like play with people or stuff like that. And in the middle of all this figuring it out, I was watching a bunch of YouTube videos on neural DSP stuff and the plugins they have, more particularly the Petrucci plugin. And so I just went and downloaded it, you know, to see if I have an old Mac, just to see if it'd work on there. And I think you get a 14-day trial. And I downloaded it. Everything worked, and it sounded amazing for what I need. I live in an apartment, so I really can't have, you know, even if I have an amp or something like that, it's really, you know, with neighbors and things like that, you can't get up too high. And if you can't turn it up enough, it doesn't sound really great. But when I did this plug-in, it blew my mind because it sounded like I've always wanted my guitar to sound. Now, to me, you know, I just wanted something that sounded good for me, that sounded good in my headphones, and that was it. I really wasn't thinking about putting it out on YouTube or anything like that at this point. And I liked it so much, I bought it. And nice. So I started playing it and enjoying it, and then I started tinkering around with the idea of maybe actually doing something on YouTube, like either recording stuff and downloading videos onto a channel of my own, or you know, like playing whenever we come on here, just, you know, behind a backing track or something like that. Right. So I kind of went down the wormhole of how do I make something that's on my computer broadcast out, because it's pretty easy when you have a piece of hardware to tell it what to do. Like if your amp is plugged in to a load box or something like that, you just tell it to whatever's going to the load box to record or to broadcast. But with software, mm-hmm. it's different. You can't just tell it to grab the software. At least the computer I had was old enough to where you couldn't do that. Right. So I went through the rabbit hole. I know there's older programs called SoundFlower, Reaper, OBS, you know, and there's Restream and things like that that you have to go through. And I would try a couple of those, and like I said, with my computer being as old as it is, it either didn't work or it took up too much of the processing power of my computer. So they were all dead ends, and I was really about just to throw my hands up and be like, you know what, I'm just gonna listen to it myself, you know, even though I would like to play online, like maybe on a show or something like that. I may just need to upgrade a computer or something beforehand, which I wasn't ready to do, both financially and, really all I use my computer for at home. So I'd all but given up on it and, you know, hadn't done any searches or anything on YouTube about it for at least a week. And I got to work one morning and was looking for something to kind of listen to, like a podcast or something like that. And I had like a suggestion feed of, you know, old videos. You know, if you looked up Gibson Les Paul, they'll every 2 weeks they'll throw a Les Paul, you know, from 10 years ago or something like that, some kind of review. And it was one of Fluff's old videos from 2021 on how he live streamed. And, I watched it. Just to see, you know, what, just because I really didn't have anything else going. There was no new content or anything on any of the subscriptions I watched. So I started watching it, and he mentions a program called Loopback. Now, disclaimer, Loopback only works on Mac devices, which me having a Mac device limited me from things like Reaper and OBX and stuff like that. They have versions for it, but it's predominantly a PC program, and it works best with PCs. We all know how Apple likes you to just only do Apple stuff, you know. And that's just part of the what it is. So, like I said, it was an old video. I didn't think that much more of it. And it showed how what it does is it is an aggregate audio device. So you can take inputs from different softwares and feed them in to the same two channels or more. And it'll spit it back out to your audio interface. And so the really cool thing about that was that I didn't need any more hardware or anything like that, and I could use my plugin. Now, the plugin that I bought, you can use through a DAW, of course, like anything else, but you can also run it standalone. And so what I could do is, and you could see right there where, you know, it's showing all your different devices. You can use iTunes, and USB microphone and all that stuff. So actually one of mine is Ableton, which is the DAW I use, and the other one is my Petrucci plugin. And so they'll run in and tie together, and you can turn one of them off if you're not using one of them or anything like that. And like I said, it had a trial period. It was 14 days. And so I tried it and I loved it. Now that cost $99. I mean, it's Apple. We know what they're doing here. But to me, it solved all of my problems, you know, because I was looking down the barrel of, you know, is it a Rodecaster I need? Is that what I need to do to make this happen? And that's, you know, $800, which sounds just spectacular. But I mean, I don't know if a Rodecaster would help me do this. I really think that I just lucked out and found this program. And I was very lucky that all of the stuff that I've done had trials, because if it was up to me to just buy it, I'm just not that kind of person where I can trust it and just buy it right off the bat.
Right.
But this is used for a lot of stuff. Like you can put your iTunes in, you know, your backing track through your iTunes if you want to. And so you're playing iTunes and I'm playing my plugin and I'm playing through Ableton. So my mic's through Ableton. It opened up a whole new world to me, and it's simple. It cost a little bit of money, but it, like I said, what I did, I already had my mic and my cables and my guitar and my interface and all that kind of stuff. So all that stuff was purchased. But to do this from all of that stuff, I paid $160 for my plug-in and $99 for loopback. And it doesn't sound amazing, but it sounds pretty darn good. So if anybody, I just know I had a hard time looking and searching out how to stream a guitar sound, because there's plenty of stuff about doing Zoom meetings and stuff like that, but nobody's using a plug-in for that. So
right.
That was kind of where I couldn't find anything and where I got lost. And like I said, I've been happy with it ever since. I hadn't put anything out yet, but I've sent Joe some examples. And yeah. It sounds good, man. Like I said,
it's
good enough
really
for me.
I thought it sounded really good, man. I mean, just, you know, I thought it sounded amazing, especially a little while ago when you was messing around and I was able to hear it through my headphones. I was like, whoa, man.
Yeah.
It's incredible. It sounds really good. I'm super glad you found that, man.
Yeah, and for some reason, I like going through loopback with the standalone of the plug-in as opposed to putting the plug-in through my DAW. I don't know why, but for some reason, I don't know if it's just the DAW's handling too much, because like I said, it's an old computer. I think the computer handles it better when they're apart as opposed to when it's trying to process mic and the DAW and the DAW pulling from the plug-in all at the same time. I think it just gets kind of... It lags a little bit and it gets kind of sputtery. So it seems to work better this way so far.
Right. That's awesome, man. I'm so glad, like I said, I'm so glad you found something to use that's, you know, because everybody's different, man. Hey, Charlie and Dogbo, what's going on, man? Hope y'all are doing good. Yeah, that's, everybody's got different.
I'm just talking about, but I mean, I won't play like a song or anything, but I can at least
go ahead, yeah.
Like what the tone sounds like.
And again, you're not going through a DAW. This is just the standalone.
Correct. This is a standalone. Now, my mic's going through the DAW, but nothing of my guitar is going through the DAW. Okay. And then, you
know, sounds good.
Got a little boosted kind of plexi tone. A little hotter.
Oh, wow.
And then some with some effects. Like I said, it works for me.
That sounds awesome. That sounds amazing. Man, that's cool. Killer, dude.
Yeah, it sounds good.
Golly.
But like I said, it fits my needs. Now, would I love to have a half stack before, you know, in here and play through that?
Oh,
I would love it.
Yeah.
But just
right.
That apartment right. Life really doesn't.
It doesn't allow that.
Doesn't yeah. Allow for that for now.
Yeah, that Blue Monk says that sounds effing amazing. It sounds great, man. I'm telling you.
Thanks, dude. And I mean,
sounds
when I
so
play
cool.
It, I was telling Joe, when I play it, it doesn't sound great in my headphones, but after I sent him the video and I listened to the video afterwards,
good, don't it?
It sounds a lot better.
That's what I deal with. If my headphones are plugged into my interface and I play something, it sounds okay. But if I listen back to it, it sounds really good. But if I have my headphones coming out of the mixer, I get the full. I mean, luckily the output signal is not being changed. It's still. You know, but I'm using a DAW, so I think that's the deciding factor for me. But yeah, Andrew, that sounds amazing, dude. Man,
thanks,
difference that made in the past couple of weeks, man.
Yeah, no, and I'm hoping that, like, we were trying to share screen before, and I don't have my stuff set up right without restarting. But once again,
right.
I'm on my little dinosaur here. But you know, next show, or you know, a couple shows down the road, we can share my screen and I can show everybody. You know, what I'm doing, and you know, a little bit about the plugin
great.
If we got time.
Absolutely. That's amazing, because it's I think it's great that, you know, if people want to play live on the internet, I think it's amazing. And it takes a little messing around to get things set up, and to, you know, it takes a little bit of work, but once you get that, man, and you get to that, you know, that little bit of level there, you'll be glad you did. You know, if you want to play, I mean, if you don't, that's different. But if you do, just going direct, it just makes a lot of difference, man. You know, and it makes it fun, you know.
But, yeah, like I said, I was about ready to be like, screw it. I don't care anymore. Just all of it go to hell. I don't care. And then I made it over that. And the good thing about all of these programs is you can save it all. So I don't have to come in here and set up my loop back every time and make sure it's pulling from the right stuff. If the devices are on when I fire up my computer, it just automatically does it.
Yeah. Yeah. That, I totally understand what you mean. Because I was in that boat years ago. I was like, man, I'm ready to throw in the towel. And then I would watch other channels. But they weren't doing nothing live, but they were, it was pre-recorded, but still, it's, I don't know, man. I would hear other people's stuff years ago, and I was like, man, why are they doing that? It sounded so great. Some people would share information, and some people was like, don't say nothing. I'm like, why? Why can't you let other people know this? And the dude wigged out on me. He went crazy. He went crazy. And so I was like, whatever, dude. Go to hell.
We all trying to get good sound. You know, we're all trying to get the same thing. There's no.
Yeah, we're all just wanting to play because this is the platform now. I mean, this is the stage is online. I mean, this is where you want to play. You know.
Yeah, you
think
I want
to playing it right, Joe?
You got to pay me to learn. Yeah, you got to pay me to play like me to sound like what I got, even though, you know.
I never understood that. If you want to hear how I got mine, it's going to cost you or something. I was like, why, dude? I mean, come on,
keep it. You can keep it.
I do this one weird trick that's hidden behind a paywall.
Behind a paywall. That's right. Well, Jimmy, you're using the Rodecaster Pro 2, right?
Yes.
Am I saying that right? Okay.
Yep.
I can see it in the frame a little bit right there. Is that it right there? Okay. Yep. So are you still really satisfied with that?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, it does the job.
So do you turn your voice mic off when you play?
Yep, I have a switch.
Gotcha.
Yeah,
up here, and never mind. I lost the ball to my SM58.
it's just hanging out there naked.
It's tied to the top of it, so it's puh, 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 so you don't hear that shit.
That's what I don't have.
Right.
So, Jimmy, I got a question. I've heard Joe say before that you don't use the DAW with a Rodecaster. Is that correct, or can you or not, or...?
It's for me, it's about as bare bones as it gets.
Yeah,
it's,
I think he is
running direct out of my Synergy preamp right into the Rodecaster.
Yeah, I think
it was the modules kind of like that went into Randall's, kind of like that. Okay,
cool.
I've heard good things about those.
Yeah, they sound great. I mean, I originally bought the Friedman BEBB module because I wanted a clean channel and a crunch channel, and the Soldano module, and boy, that was like, geez, nearly 6 years ago, and I've been completely happy with it. I mean, now they've got, you know, there's a ton of modules, and I listen to them, and it's like, well, there's nothing that just wows me enough to want to spend another $400 on a module. Right. It's like I can basically just finagled pretty much any kind of sound because I, you know, I've got tons of EQing available, you know, on my rack there with my Behringer Pro Q, and then I got a bunch of DOD FX40B graphic equalizers, and I run two of them in my loop, one on each side because I'm running stereo out of the preamp, and then it goes into, and then I'm turning it into an actual stereo channel on the Rodecaster, and I've been messing around with it, and some people have noticed that I've been, you know, screwing around with it, you know, like John Deshane gave me crap last week because I was messing with it, and I couldn't even tell the difference, but apparently on the other end it just sounded like complete ass, and I was like, yep, okay.
Well, so, okay.
Love you, John.
But. Blue Mox, he says OU812 and Mr. Wentz, the crew, and I do mean all of them, inspire me so much. It has literally changed my life in a positive way. Seriously, thank you, man. Blue Mox, that's really nice.
I agree with that. I agree with that.
Thank you so much, man.
I found Joe after I bought a PV Wolfgang special. I found Joe, and from Joe, I found Ryan. You know, R2, and I found Ryan. And then through Ryan, I found Under the Bus. I mean, just a bunch of great people in this community and a bunch of great channels.
Absolutely.
I mean, just good stuff.
Yeah, very nice. Thank you.
So who in the setups, who plays with an amp in the background? Anybody? Or are you just doing headphones? Like, Jimmy, you just...
Everybody's going direct, I think.
Andrew's just direct. Because I know OU went 812 as his amp on.
But I'm also... So I'm running a speaker cab, too, at the same time.
Right.
And it's a lot better. To be able to feel it.
Yeah.
Because I'm totally used to, you know, standing in front of a loud cab all the time. And,
yeah,
you know, you miss that, you know, guitar speaker connection, you know, that you lose with just, you know, going completely silent. So I just,
yeah,
you know, 3 feet from a 4x12 cabinet.
And that's right.
Yeah. It's just up loud enough to get some feedback.
Yeah.
And then just be able to, you know, feel it a little bit.
You know? So you're micing your cabs and Ryan mics his stuff as well. Is that correct?
I have no mic on the cab. You hear is just the direct out.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And then the cabinet's just for me.
Okay.
Because I'm selfish.
Okay.
So the direct out and the cab works at the same time? I didn't know if one of them would like cut. Okay, cool.
Yep. And there's no latency between the two, so.
That's what I was, okay, that's awesome. Okay. All right.
I have a microphone, but I also have the, the two notes captor, which I could run into the audio interface. What I don't have is the ability to turn this off easily. So I think that's where that's where it gets watery when it comes through here.
Yeah.
Underwater. Yeah, leaving the mic on.
Right. Yeah.
That's kind of annoying to have to turn the mic off all the time, though.
It is. That's why.
Is that a USB mic?
No, this is XLR.
Okay. Get one of those cables that have the switch.
The switch.
Integrated into the cable.
Could do that.
Yeah.
I could do that. I always think about getting a new mic, but this one's kind of okay.
Yeah.
What's the point?
Nathan, what about your setup, man? Talk about your setup for a second.
I just do most of my stuff just comes from the Helix. So I run the Helix through a couple pedals into a mixer into the Studio 1810C.
1810C, yeah.
And I got a little patch crazy when I got the Helix. I was like, oh my god, this is the coolest thing in the world, and started getting all kind of different patches from, you know, George Lynch, Warren DeMartini, stuff like that. So that's what I did all during Christmas, was just mess with this thing.
Now let me ask you something about that Helix, because there's other people I've heard ask this question. You have one, so I'm going to ask you. Is it aggravating going through everything with that Helix, or is it something you enjoy doing, or is there a bunch of presets that sound pretty good, or does it really shine when you buy the patches?
I bought patches from two guys. There's this one guy, Glenn, cannot remember his last name, but he's got like his own channel and all that, where he does all the custom patches. I loved all of his, so I kind of stuck with him. I got another couple patches from somebody off the marketplace who had like their own shop or whatever, and those were okay. They weren't fantastic, but I will say 100% of the ones I got from the other guy were phenomenal.
So the unit as a whole, I mean, are you satisfied with that unit?
Oh yeah.
Do you find it easy to work with, or is it kind of take a little work?
It's no more complicated than anything else out there, really. I mean, you have anything that's, you know, more, because we're going to the digital world age, right? So everything's, you know, it's about the same. To be honest, it's no more complicated than working like your cell phone or your tablet or any, or, you know, whatever.
Right. It's just a little learning curve, right?
Yeah.
Well, I'm kind of interested to see what the next generation is going to be with this stuff from Line 6, now that Yamaha has has bottom. And I mean, if you recall back in, I think it was like 2000, is Yamaha came out with the DG series of amplifiers and stomp boxes and preamps. And that stuff was pretty cool. I mean, at the time, for being all digital, I mean, it, you know,
right.
hit the button and all the knobs turned by themselves.
That's the dog pup. I saw him in the chat. That's there's, him.
There's a bear out there. But I thought that was pretty cool. I mean, back then, I still had... So I bought another Rodecaster Pro 2, and I'm going to set it up out in my other room and do shit from out there, but I think what I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna take that DG stomp because it's got all kinds of inputs and, you know, digital out and stereo out. So I'm gonna just make a whole nother setup in my living room and do shit from out there. But I'm really interested to see what that, you know, 25-year-old piece of technology is gonna sound like out there, and if I can manipulate it enough to make it sound good. I mean, I've never ever used it in a capacity like this, so I kind of really interested to see what happens with that.
Yeah, me too. It's funny you say that, because there's some things I've seen, I'm sure y'all have too, where they'll go back to old pieces of gear and they'll say, how does this sound like today? Like the old Zoom stuff. What was that thing I had back in the day, that old Zoom? What was it, a 505
guitar effects or processor? Something. Yeah, something. The 505 was popular.
Yeah, it had the two up and down pedals on it. And I remember when I had that all those years ago, I was like, this is the stuff, man. This is awesome. And then you go back into it now and you're probably like, what was I thinking? But, you know, it was different technology back then, you know.
We were the lucky generation to get the DOD grunge pedal.
It was
wonderfully awesome.
Supra metal.
Nice.
Yeah, I remember that. And I remember when they came out later, after that 505, a little bit later, they came out with, like, I think George Lynch model. Y'all remember that?
Yeah.
I remember that song. I actually saw that had on Reverb not long ago.
Yeah, had the scary preset.
Yeah. It's supposedly, yeah. It's just fun to go back on memory lane and listen to some of that stuff. And you know, it's like, man, golly, I used to have that stuff, man. I look at it and I'm like, wow, man, things have come a long way, a very long way.
I mean, even in the past 5 years, I mean, you got to think, Kemper is what, 10 years old? And I mean,
I didn't know it was that old.
I think Kemper's 10 or 11 years old, 2010, maybe more than that then. Yeah, 2010, I think, is when they came out. But just how that changed everything, and then how absolutely bonkers it went after that. Because, like, with the Prime, you know, it's got a cloud, too. And your Spark, it has its own cloud, you know. And all this stuff, there's just material everywhere. It's just, it's insane.
It's crazy. Let me ask, it's going to be a... Excuse my ignorance, but I don't know nothing really about the Kemper. So I know you said those have been out for a while. So isn't that mainly what people, if they're playing live, you know, I guess, aren't they kind of using that for like their main amp now instead of taking out a cabinet or something? I mean, it's...
There's several different kinds. I had a Kemper Powerhead, which that comes with a power amp in it.
Okay.
And so you could just hook that up to a cabinet or whatever and go. If it's not a power head, you have to plug it into a power amp and then, you know, get an auxiliary power and do that. But I just had the head. Now, since then, they've come out with the Stage, which is a floor model, and they just came out with a new little one. But I've been out of the game. I've been out of that game so long, I don't even know. I think they all operate on the same system, but for me, Kemper was, it came loaded with some stuff, but like the benefit of it being around for so long is there's so many things you can find, you know, so many good sounds that you can find.
Yeah,
but also the bad thing about that is there's so many bad things you have to weed through. And I didn't like it because of the menu dive. Like, you know, the Prime, you just drop, drag, and you're good. Yeah. There's no touch screen for the Kemper, and there's no pictures, you know, there's no graphics or anything like that. So, you know, if you need to change a parameter, you just push a button, and it might be a button to edit it. You push and hold, or you might have to push this button and then hit edit over here, or you just have to plug the thing into your computer and do it that way. And to me, that was too much work. I'm too impatient to go through all that. You find some great stuff, but if you want to play a guitar, you need to spend the day before getting your shit ready, your sounds ready, so you can just plug in and play guitar the next day. And I didn't like that.
Yeah, I've always heard that it was a lot to deal with the Kemper stuff. That it's a huge learning curve. I don't know. That's just what I heard other people say. I don't know. I've never messed with
it. It was.
Yeah.
It turned me off really a lot.
It was kind of the first generation of the current. Mm-hmm. You know, Neural DSP, Headrush Prime, right? They were all next after that Kemper.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Right?
That's interesting.
They all do the same thing. You bring them and you plug them in the front of the house, right?
Right. Yeah. I mean, you can. Yeah.
You can, yeah. And
now you got Tone Master, and then you've got some that do just amps like Tone X, or even the IRX is in that because it's, you know, it's a preamp with an IR section in the back. A digital.
Just catch the cat already, Jesus.
He wants something to eat. He's being a little bastard.
It's time for dinner.
Yeah. I just fed him before we came on, so he wouldn't do that. Yeah, he's like, I'm done with that. I'm ready for some more.
Sound like my cat. Feed her, and 10 minutes later, she's like, "Where's some more?"
I imagine next, it's going to be AI built into these things.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Right? You're going to say, hey, give me this song. Give me this tone. And it'll put it together for you.
Hey, it could be, man. That's a great thought.
I don't have any experience with a Helix, but when I watched Nathan, you and Joe, and Nathan was just clicking through artist models, I mean, you just click of a button and it sounded just like Slash, or you know, just like Dire Straits, or just like anything. I mean, that blew me away. So that was really cool.
Crazy.
Yeah, when I went to my son's house yesterday to try to help him, because now we have the same mixer, so I was trying to help him get set up so we have a better sound doing this internet stuff. And Helix. Yeah, his Helix was on the Warren D. Martini tone, and he's sitting there playing. I was like, wow, it sounds just like it. It was incredible. I mean, it was spot on. To me, it was, you know. But yeah, very nice. And you got that used, didn't you, Nathan? Didn't you buy that used off of Reverb? Well, hey, when you get a minute, get your stuff on, you can play give us a chord or something, if you feel like it.
Yeah,
see what it sounds like. Yeah, if you want to. Jimmy, was you wanting to play tonight by any chance?
I got a question.
Yeah,
Jimmy.
I got a couple songs to play tonight.
So okay, well, Andrew, we'll go ahead.
I just wanted to know what that reverse headstock Tele looking guitar was behind you. I was eyeballing that. It looks cool.
Oh, here we go.
This is a parts guitar. It's all PV parts.
Nice.
But it's a PV Generation S2 body with a maple. It's actually quite a thick maple cap on it, on a mahogany body. And then it's just a reverse headstock tracer neck.
Looks good.
It's just like everything I like. I like the Charvel style too. I like the Tele style stuff.
Yeah.
And then the reverse headstock on it. It's just
raging ball.
Find from the pain on a sign. Is there anyone who really recalls?
That was, sorry, that was Nathan. Sorry, I'm
keep going. We're partying up in hell. Let's go.
So this is the guitar that's going to get this thing in it.
Oh, the tremolo.
Oh, that came in.
Yeah.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, we will stay tuned for that,
when I'm
Mr. Biter.
Done screwing down with everything else.
Nice, man.
Route that thing now on there.
Routed.
Test time, Jimmy Biter.
No routing required on there.
Oh,
yeah. It's not an E, John. It's in
Drop C sharp.
Uh-oh. Shots fired. Man. Goodness gracious alive. Yeah.
Now cool, the Charbel's man. An E.
Oh. I like that. That's
you guys
nice,
want to see man. That guitar?
He's great.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, sure.
We absolutely do.
Absolutely, so, yeah.
This is a 1991 Charvel 475 Deluxe Exotic.
That is awesome.
Nice.
What the hell? I mean, it's got some flame on the top. It's not, you know, overly exaggerated, but it's also flamed on the back.
Nice. As
well. Doesn't not really show it up. It's my sex lights that I got on. See, I'm hitting everything.
That's why your mic's falling apart.
So it's got the Schaller Floyd. These came with that like that little mid boost gizmo thing in the electronics. Yeah. And it was removed. And apparently at some point this guitar belonged to Larry DiMarzio. Because he has a house here in the valley. I've done some repair work to his house and whatnot.
Dang.
And we got mutual friends. So I had a friend who's got a recording studio here, and he's all friends with Larry DiMarzio. So,
wow,
this guitar somehow made it to Billings, and a guy that I've known since high school that kind of, you know, pushed me into getting, you know, more serious when I was, you know, before I had graduated. Now owns a guitar shop in Billings, and he had this sitting there, and I was like, shit, it's a toothpaste logo Charvel. And so
that's awesome.
I bought it. So nice guitar. It's I fight with this thing. I really want to play it, but it's something just doesn't, I mean, it plays great. It just doesn't really sound the way I want it to. And, you know, and that, with the no flange pickup.
Right.
And it is, I've got two Air Nortons in it right now.
Okay.
And that was just to fill the holes. So this guitar's, I've had this since 2017.
Okay.
And so one day I'll do something and it'll sound good, but I'm, you know, you say, I bought it for $400 and now you go and look on Reverb or Evil Bay, and things are north of $1,200 now.
Wow. R2 says send it his way. He'll make it sound right.
Put it in E flat. Maybe that'll do it.
Technically still E.
Oh, God.
Route it.
Oh, my gosh.
I want to see some live on-air routing.
Yeah,
Alex 2112. What's going on, Alex? He says, "Jimmy, I have a 475 as well. Do you have the chainsaw case?"
No, do not.
No, okay. Huh?
Chainsaw case.
All right. Let's see if Nathan's ready to give us a couple of examples with his Helix. There, are you ready, son?
Oh yeah,
chlorine burst Charvel.
I like that. Beautiful guitar. Beautiful, beautiful guitar. Cushman, NYC. What is going on, man? How are you? Thank you for being here. All right, son, what you going to do for us? Sounds
yeah.
amazing,
yeah.
dude.
Yeah. That growls. Awesome. Growls.
And sounds what profile really were you on there?
Oh, what, that was what? The Warren DeMartini one.
Okay.
Right on. Cool, man. Very nice. Very nice.
I like the, like when you went through all the different versions of Eddie's tone, it was just like, this is 84. This is that. And I was just like, what the crap? Like, you just a click of a button and you're there.
It was insane.
Do you have that, Nathan?
Oh, man, somewhere. I'd have to look for it.
Okay, well, don't. That's okay. If it's too much stuff, don't worry about it.
Because that's like, I remember there was one, I can't remember if I saved it or not, but there was one that I sent Dad a video about, and I hit it. Within a click of a button, it was doing the crazy ginormous bar dive thing that Eddie was using with all the delay for at the end of Eruption, and it was perfect.
Oh yeah. You did that. You sent that to me. You hit that and hit that effect. I said, "Wow, it sounded just like it."
It was insane.
That's cool, man. That's awesome. Very cool. That sounds amazing.
Yeah, it sounds good.
If you want to play a song later, let me know.
I said I think I got it plugged up. So.
Oh, okay. Well, if you're ready now, go ahead. Yeah. Let's see what we got here. Mr. Mick in the chat. What is going on, man?
Up homes.
Hope you're doing good. All right. Jimmy, you got something lined up?
Yep.
Okay.
Nice.
Remember, I've got some crap from TeamU that I haven't opened yet that I want to look at here. I'm betting that it's probably.
Oh, that's right. We gotta check out the stuff from TeamU that he bought. We can do that while Nathan's getting his stuff lined up.
Yeah. So you want to go through the fake Seymour Duncans that you find on eBay?
We'll do that real quick, and Nathan, we'll come back to you. That,
yeah. That's fine.
We'll come back until somebody won't need a lot of dead air. All right, go ahead. What we got there?
So I bought that pickup.
Tell us the story. Here.
So I was looking for Seymour Duncan Customs because I like that pickup. Let me get that in there. Okay, so that's what I bought. Right, as soon as I opened the package up, I was like, "All right, this doesn't look right." So says Seymour Duncan. It's the right color. It's in silver that they use on the, like the parchment or whatever, like the off white or cream and white bobbins.
Right.
But we'll sitting there looking at it, and it's like, well, why does that look weird? It's like the font's too small.
Oh, look at that. That's a legit one right there.
Yep. So this is the black one's a legit one. It's not going to focus. That? It's just going to piss me off. So you can see the size difference, even though it's not focusing. Wow. All that great.
Yeah, just think of how many people don't have.
Look at the pole pieces on the slug coil are like tiny compared. And then I'm sitting there looking at the thing and looking at the real Seymour Duncan. I was like, well, okay, so when I turn it, you got the Seymour Duncan logo and all that.
Mm-hmm.
Is, right side up, according to the pickup.
Well, it is
upside down on the fake one.
Oh, wow.
And you ever seen a Seymour Duncan that had single holes? Because they don't, because they always use three.
Oh, there we go.
Mm.
Wow.
So it's fake. And then the other giveaway is on the adjustable pole pieces. Is there's like a little, they're like self-tapping pieces or screws. So they got this little wedge on the end of the screw to, cut threads as you're going through something. Not on here.
Wow.
So, and the pickup sounds like ass.
So did you pay full price for that? Because that's kind of when
no, so this isn't new. I paid like
strings.
I paid like $35 for it. And I didn't send it back because I was like, okay, well, this will be something good to have because I can look at this and go, okay, now I know what a fake one looks like.
Wow. Dang.
On there, but eBay. Some company in China is just pumping fake ones out. They're selling sets for like, you know, for like 50, 60 bucks, you can have, you know, JB and a Jazz. And it's like, nope, they're not.
Wow. Somebody's getting ripped. Man. Mr. De Silva, how are you, man?
The bad thing is someone could go resell it and not know that it's fake, you know? Yep.
And I think that's what happened. It's possible. I didn't say anything. I didn't tell the seller. It's like, oh, you sold me a fake pickup, because it's like, well, it was only $35, and it's like, well, this is good knowledge to have. Now I got one in my hand. I see what the differences are.
Oh man.
And I put it in, you know, I put it in the guitar, and it sounds like ass.
Dang, man. Golly. Mm.
Man, it's hard to buy used stuff nowadays.
Yeah, it's scary, man. Yeah. Scary.
Damn.
So what else you got, Jim? You got any of that Temu stuff available? Or?
Yeah. You want to let Nathan
okay, let's see if
melt Nathan's her faces ready. Off? And
you ready, cool. Son?
Yeah, sure thing.
Okay. I think that was a what was that? E flat.
Yeah, that was
an E flat. Okay. Well, that's all right. Pick you another one out. Pick you another. Pick
show
you another
some
one
more
out.
Timu.
And show some more Timu. All right. Let's let him get resituated. We'll go back.
Our
to
was right. It probably would have went better if you just started moonwalking.
Oh man, that's all right. That's all right. All right, Timu time, Mr. Jimmy. Timu time.
Okay, well.
Yes, sir. So we're going to let him get resituated.
I seen a bunch of crap on Timu because, you know, I was like, oh, well, I want to shop like a billionaire. So I bought some random stuff, and it's like, okay, let's just see what they got here because, okay, you know, low, low price.
Okay, let's see what we got here.
So I started off, I was like, okay, they had these weird, it's like hardwood radius blocks for, okay, you know, leveling your frets. So they had a bunch of different sizes, so I got some of the ones that of the ones that I need. 17-inch for my Ibanez Wizard necks.
Mm-hmm.
15-inch for my PV Tracer necks. All
right.
And a 12-inch for my my single cuts and like my JS and all that that have the 12-inch radius. They're fairly close. I'll probably have to sand on them a little bit to get them perfect. But totally, they're usable.
And so you just, do you attach your different grits of sandpaper to that and just use,
yep,
that to level?
Yeah, okay. they sent like, I don't know, it's probably 400 grit paper with them. So,
oh,
we use that up. So, and then I got this. This is like a guitar repair kit. I haven't opened it yet. So we're going to, I'm assuming it's going to be a botched abortion inside the case.
Uh-oh.
Because, what, you know, look at, you know, McDonald's, you see their, you know, billboard. Hey, look at this pretty hamburger. And then you go there and it's like, what the fuck is this?
is that a Case Logic this? Case?
Yeah.
Case Logic.
So this is going to be the first time that it's opened. So
okay,
I'm just going to
okay,
figure that this thing
here.
Is. So I'm going to assume that this is going to be a mess in here. And oh, yep, it's a mess.
Oh my God.
There's supposed to be little, oh, little all these little things and whatnot that holds everything. But yeah, it's a mess
everywhere.
Oh, wow. So let's see what we got here. So we got polishing stone and some fret protectors.
Okay.
Sex lights are fucking everything up again.
Oh.
Fret guards. Okay. Nice. That's doable. I could always use more of those.
Yeah.
String winder. I throw these things away because every time I get a pickup from like Banjo Mike or one of them guys on eBay, as they send me all that stuff, so I've, you know, I've got a box of those things.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it must be some antiperspirant for tiny armpits. Okay. So I think what this is it's a, like a little pad that's, yeah, it's got some kind of oil on it. I'm assuming that you rub it on your fingerboard to condition it, but stuff smells like motor oil.
Oh, Lord.
Makes you run faster.
Yeah. I'll try it on one of my crap necks in there, in the trunk, and see what it does. So, and then, oh yeah, this is awesome. So this is totally useless. I'm sorry, I'm not doing drywall in my house. My drywall's fine. That's what this is a drywall sanding sponge.
You could do a drywall guitar.
Yeah, it'd be a little dusty.
I think if any of us can, you can, Jimmy.
Well, yeah. I mean, I'm sure it's possible. But
what's up, Tony? Yeah, how you doing, man?
this thing's it's useless. Oh, unless I need to sand, you know, to sand on the body or something, one of the raw ones. But yeah, that'll just go into my work case with my drywall tools.
Oh, wow.
So these, okay, what do we got here? I'm just going to open this. Ow.
Oh, be careful.
Everything's falling off. So, oh, look at that. So it's an acetylene torch tip cleaner. Well, I might be playing guitar and then all of a sudden get the urge to do some welding. One of them fell off. I'm going to step on that bastard, and it's going to go through my foot.
Oh, what? No.
There it is.
Was it supposed to be nut files?
Yeah, they're supposed to be nut files. You know, I've been down that road, and it's like, yeah, they kind of work. They're good enough to like smooth a rough spot in your nut, but not to cut one.
No.
They're all bent up and everything. So, yeah. So, more garbage.
Oh, wow.
So, this will just go with my welding stuff.
When somebody has to borrow it, give them those.
Yeah. Get out the crap. We got some. I'm going to assume those are they're bronze strings.
Oh, okay.
But I don't know if they're for an acoustic guitar or an electric guitar. They're awful thin. It probably looks like a 9 to 42. What? But why are they bronze?
Again, if you're just tuning in, Jimmy is showing some items he got for his guitar stuff through Timo.
And some nylon tortoise picks. Blue. One blue one, four purple, one and a black one.
Yeah.
So those will go in the jar. Get a little pair of fret nippers. Why is everything in plastic? It's in a damn case. Jeez. So these suck because they got the groove in the top of them, so you can't really cut something flush with them. So I'd have to take these to the grinder and just grind that flat.
Oh, wow.
For them to be, you know, useful as far as guitar goes. I mean, it's not, Jesus, because these things suck. Look at it. It's not even straight.
You cut strings with it or something.
Dare I say, may I ask, how much did this kit cost?
I think it was like $28.
Okay.
So, I mean, that's why I'm not feeling bad about, you know, this, because, you know, it's just like, you know, no price. You want sushi with that? feeler gauges. You can always use more feeler gauges. I'm cutting the bastards up to shim whatever, necks or, you know.
Right.
Whatever, so they're always covered in oil. It's like they're made of stainless steel. Why do you got to cover them with oil?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, they are. Hands. They're nasty.
Thickness right. gauge. Yeah, thanks. I'm surprised you even spelled it right.
That's right, Ryan. Timu, it should be called Screw You.
That's right. So I've we got a bag of
from Timu. Yeah,
we got a so these shirts. I bought all these cool shirts from Timu.
Oh,
I got like tons and tons of you know, yeah. just you know, shirts. Imagine I got like 15 of them of these different
oh
shirts.
Oh my god!
So imagine I enjoy that. The, I love that shirt. Yeah, go ahead.
Just imagine them printing that over there.
They probably don't care.
So we got a bag of nice... of acoustic guitar bridge pins, a injection molded nut. Oh Jesus, that thing is hollow. It's Uh-oh. Hollow. Oh my God! And then a bridge saddle.
Jimmy's got his own wow. deer famers. He doesn't need your nuts.
Yeah. I still have chunk of it left.
There still isn't even enough tools
that
in there
impressive,
yet.
That's impressive, by the way.
So, and then we got some black ones.
Nice. Okay.
And I don't own any acoustics anymore, so.
We still can't hook up a guitar at Guitar Center with this kid.
And then we got still some diamond look. Files.
Oh.
Oh, I think I have like those.
Four or well, five
the
of
cheap
these sets
ones
already.
Those on Amazon are 20
oh, wow.
bucks. So.
And they're, I mean, I use these for like doing little detailing thing. If I just got to take tiny little bits off.
Yeah.
On there. So not too bad.
Those are good. Those are useful.
So that's a positive.
That's
like
28 bucks right there.
Okay.
We got some, what I'm going to assume, are some overly soft Allen wrenches. That will probably the minute I put them in a Torx set or into a nut is they'll probably strip right off.
Yeah, been down that road.
Oh, yeah. We got yeah. some looks like a cleaning cloth.
Oh,
tiny. Okay. Yeah. Oh, you know, tiny hands. It's like, I can't make it too big. So it's dope. Basically just a cloth you get with your glasses.
Yeah. There you go. You can clean
but,
your glasses.
But I actually prefer this
color.
Stuff over the microfiber. Yeah. Stuff because the microfiber ones leave shit all over your all over your guitar and your yeah. strings. I mean, they're good for, you know, doing right. if you're doing some heavy duty cleaning. But right. if you're polishing them,
yeah.
these things work best.
Okay.
And
very nice.
That's the cleanup after you use your feeler gauges.
Yeah.
Yeah. There you go.
And a Fritz ruler. I don't know
oh,
who
yeah.
this Fritz guy
oh,
is.
Oh, okay.
But, I mean, the back is a big abortion of stuff. It's how you supposed to read that.
I have one of those.
So,
what
I
is
know.
That?
I never use gauges. I always go by feel.
Headstock. Oh,
measurements be damned.
Yeah, I don't never use those either.
So that was pretty much it. So
I think with the diamond files and the case logic case, you got your money's
oh,
worth.
Oh, I forgot one thing. Oh, probably the best thing in the case.
Oh. Here we go.
And that's some radius gauges.
Nice.
Oh.
So okay. I'll definitely use these. I just got to check to make sure that they are what they say they are.
Oh, okay.
15, right. 16, 9.5 for you Fender guys, and 17, 20, ooh, right, nylon guitar type stuff, what is this one, 12, 7 and a quarter, a 10, and a 14, so, good all the popular sizes.
Yeah, so
I'll definitely use those.
So 1 out of 10, Jimmy. 10 being the best, 1 being the worst. With this,
three.
With this thing you bought from Timu, what would you give it?
3.
A 3. Ooh,
yeah, 3.
That's low. Okay, all yeah. right.
I mean, most of the stuff in there is just crap.
Okay, wow. I think you could use what, maybe 2 or 3 items out of that.
Yeah, I mean stuff that'll hang around. I mean, you could use this over, you know. Use it up over the good tools.
Okay.
And then I also ended up getting some fret erasers.
Oh, nice.
Plus. I'm sure it makes a huge difference.
Yeah, the regular ones are no good.
Yeah. We changed the color. Great. So we got 2,000 grit, 1,500 grit, 1,000 grit, 400 grit, 180 grit. So we'll see how these do. So, you're probably asking, Jim, will you be buying more stuff from Temu? And I am going to say no. Go fuck yourself.
Yeah, I've never ordered anything from there, and I thought that was interesting. Let's just see. Oh, that's great, man.
So, yeah.
That's great.
So, I had to see, you know?
You had to give it a shot. Yeah,
it was, exactly. I mean, for the kit and the erasers and the blocks, I think it was less than $50. So I was like, well, I'll spend $50 just to see.
Right.
On there. So what I didn't get was I had also ordered the notch straight edge.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
For checking your, neck relief or making sure if you're going to do fret work that it's flat. And I never got it.
Uh-oh.
So I just contacted them and was like, yeah, this wasn't in the package because all the shirts, I had, 15 shirts and then the guitar repair kit and the radius blocks and the erasers. And they just threw it in a like thin bag. And then since it was, coming across borders, you could tell that at one point it was opened and they mussed around in it a little bit. And then taped it back up. And I don't know, maybe the bag was too small to have, because the thing was like over 2 feet long.
Wow.
Metal bar. And I was like, well, where's this at? So.
Yeah.
So they refunded me. I didn't even realize until today that I didn't get it. And so it's been over 2 weeks since I've had this stuff. And then I was like, oh, crap. So, but it was like $8.38. So I just like, give me a refund. I didn't get it. They didn't even fight me. It's like 5 minutes later after I requested the refund. It's like, oh, okay, you got your refund. And it's like, okay, that was strangely quick. And he didn't ask me any questions.
Ryan says you're going to order a pickup from Temu later tonight.
Yeah. I'm going to get all effed up. And
yeah.
Be drinking and smoking, I'm going to order a fake JB.
Oh, my God. That's too damn funny. Oh, my God. So, y'all are quick, boy.
Larry says, see more pumpkin.
That's too damn good, man. Oh, y'all are quick. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. So, so now I got some junk. I'll probably just take the stuff that's garbage, like the acoustic bridge pins and all that. And the nut and the saddle, okay, that's junk. It's just garbage. I mean, I wouldn't put that on a Squire.
Put that on a Squire. Damn. Oof. All right. That's amazing. Interesting. Very interesting.
Yeah.
My stepdaughter, they're in town. They're here through Monday. And I asked her if she ever ordered anything from Temu. She's like, yeah. Got my phone case from Temu and I got this other stuff. She goes, it's okay. She goes, it's, don't expect a lot because you're not going to get a lot. And I said, I was just wondering, not because I was thinking about you. I wonder if he's going to show that stuff off tonight. So I'm glad you did.
I mean, they've got tens of thousands of pages of just shit.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable. It's like Amazon 2.0.
Yeah,
on there, but like I said, I got all these cool shirts from there. It's like, oh, okay, well, I mean, awesome.
That's right.
So, Temu, worse than Walmart.
Mr. John says, rip us up a tune, Jimmy. Let me see if Jimmy wants to do that. Nathan, are you ready?
No. Let Jimmy go.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Oh, that was fast. Ryan says this is a maybe pickup, not JB pickup. Yeah, I'd be, oof. I'm glad he showed that stuff off, because I was like, I wonder what it'd be like to order from there.
It's pretty obvious. I mean, when you're on eBay and you see, and it's like you're searching for pickups, and if you're searching for Seymour Duncans, is that stuff comes up in like your suggestions. They'll give you like a, you know, you scroll down the page and they'll give you, people also bought this. And it's like, no, they didn't just buy this because this is crap.
They didn't.
Oh my God. And it's somebody's doing it. I mean, they've got tons and tons of I don't know if you call them counterfeit, just copies or whatever you want to call them. They're not Seymour Duncans. But they look like Seymour Duncans in the picture. I don't know if they're actually using like real pictures of Seymour Duncans in their listings. And then sending, you know, then you get sent that, and they're like, ha ha, stupid American.
Yeah. You just got your $25. You stupid dummy. Andrew, you're crazy, man. Golly, boy. All right, let's see what Mr. Jimmy has for us.
Get on.
What he's got for us today, this evening.
Let's do a sound check. Turn that kill switch off.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yes, sir.
Money,
sir. That sounds good.
We got you.
Money.
Okay. Well, let's see. What song are we doing here? I'm going to, because I've been in, so, you know, it's being Easter weekend. I'm not a religious guy, but, I mean, kids, I mean, okay, Easter Bunny. I wanted to eat a rabbit. I wanted Haas and Pepper for Easter. Yeah. Couldn't do that. Yeah. The lady next door is attached to the rabbit that's eating her flowers. So I've been in kind of a hot mood today because somebody, like, I think two doors down, somebody was having a birthday party.
Oh,
great. But when you start parking in my yard, I got a problem. Uh-oh. I don't give a shit about your birthday. So I had to yell at, like, there was probably, probably like 15 vehicles. And I go outside to have a smoke, and they're parked in my yard.
Uh-oh.
And so... naturally, well, here comes, you know, that just instantly brings the asshole out in Jim. It's just like, get the F out of my yard. Dang. Holy shit. Where do you live? Can you tell me where you live? Because I'm going to come to your house and I'm just going to park in your yard. Maybe I'll take a shit too.
Throw that Temu stuff in the yard.
Yeah. I did buy a slingshot from Temu just because there's some ravens at the job site that are pissing me off and getting into my dump trailer.
We're officially the old guys. Get off my lawn. Oh, yeah, there's R2.
After the show, I'm going to go yell at clouds for about a half hour. I'm kind of in a metal mood today. So
okay.
Nice. All right.
So that's what you're going to get is some heavy.
Okay. Sounds good. That sounds good.
Here we go.
Yeah.
dude, that was incredible.
There you go.
Awesome, man.
A little bit of corrosion and conformity. King of the Rotten.
That's freaking awesome, man. That was awesome. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. I hit the spot. I'm in a metal mood too.
Yeah, that was right awesome. Randy, what's going on, man? I want you to come on the show one time too, man. I'd love to have you on. Randy Price, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, what's up, Randy?
Randy.
That was awesome, man. That was awesome, dude. Let's see here. I'm trying to look at the comments, man. People showing Jimmy some love here. Thank y'all for doing that.
Right on. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Like, love to hear some live music on here. Yeah. It was awesome, dude.
Yep. Awesome music, parts guitar.
There you go.
You know, it's crazy. Is Peavey on eBay? You know, they have their little website on there because they're still getting rid of crap.
Uh-huh.
And so they have a Peavey Wolfgang hardtail body, similar to this, except there's something going on down here that doesn't look all that great, kind of looks horrible, but it's intended to be a painted body, right? I bought this body for $175.
Wow.
It's a PV body. The other body that they have on their site, I mean, looks like ass, and they want $800 for it.
What?
$800. I was like, what the hell are you guys smoking?
Yeah.
Is the asbestos and lead paint at there in Meridian finally getting to you?
Paint.
I couldn't believe it. I mean, I'd like to buy another body. I'd like to find another hardtail body.
Yeah.
But not for $800.
No, not for $800, man. Slick
just
Ricky
like,
Hole in the chat. What's up, Slick Rick?
Slick Rick.
Thank you for being here, man. Yeah, that was great, man.
Yeah. Absolutely. So if you find even if you know you find yourself a you know the PV bodies, the EVH. I mean, this is a Wolfgang standard neck.
Yeah.
And they fit right in the PV stuff.
That's cool, dude.
So that's how I solved wanting a, you know, a hardtail Peavey Wolfgang.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean,
just a Wolfgang in general.
Really didn't, at first I really didn't jive on the hardtail Peavies. And seeing you and R2 play them, they're really starting to grow on me, man.
Yeah. And, I mean, occasionally they'll pop up, whether it's a, you know, of course the Peavey ones, you know, okay, well, if you got $3,000 or $4,000 you want to spend, more power to you.
Yeah,
even the EVH models, like there were a couple Japan made ones, and those are the Japanese special. They have a flat top, or this is, this is a carved top on there, and people want those. They're still in demand, and so it's $1,000 or more, probably asking for more than what they were worth new.
Oh wow.
And of course, a lot of them have damage. I mean, some of them, it's like, okay, come on, dude. It's got a great big ding where you dropped it. So it's like, you're still trying to get $1,200 out of it. And it's like,
$1,200 mullet.
So.
No.
But I wish they would. I wish EVH would make more hardtails.
Oh, really?
Man. Yeah. As in a hardtail configuration, I absolutely love the Wolfgang. I'm just not a big fan of dive-only Floyds.
Right, yeah, floating. You like floating. Yeah.
Yep. That's why I rounded one out to be floating, because it's like what I want.
Right.
But I would absolutely buy more Wolfgangs if they just made some hardtails.
Yeah.
And there's people all over. It's like, yeah, we want hardtail ones.
R2 agrees. He goes, I love my Japan Wolfgang hardtail. It's my number one right now. How about that? Edwin Crane, I ain't seen you in a long time, man. What's going
What's
on?
Up,
he goes, hello from South Carolina.
Hey, Edwin.
Another South Carolina folk? Wow.
Hello from South Carolina.
Yeah, Edwin's down around Anderson, I believe. Yeah.
I heard that.
Man, he probably got one of the, he probably got one of them squatted trucks.
Carolina squat.
I thought they outlawed those. Yeah. We were at Myrtle Beach and they were everywhere. Like we went up to visit Myrtle Beach we hadn't been there in a while. I'm from South Carolina, but I live in Florida now. Yeah. So we went up there and they were everywhere, all lit up. Just
they're ugly, man.
Pulling those imaginary trailers, those invisible trailers are crazy down there, man.
They're loaded down.
They're ugly.
Yeah. That way, when you hit somebody else, you go flying right over the top of them.
Yeah,
so you can see.
They look weird. Guitar Man 45, how are you, man?
Bo,
how are you doing, sir,
brother?
Is Hardtails, is that a big in the drop tuning community? It's better than dealing with Floyd, right?
Well, I mean, yeah, I suppose. I mean, if it's decked, it's, you know, not any real issue. But I can't really answer that. I just love Hardtails, you know.
Yeah, they're good.
Most of the time, a lot of my Hardtail guitars are, you know, in some whatever tuning, whether it's drop C or B or.
I just like the feel of a Tune-O-Matic bridge too, like that. That's a Squire and it's a Hardtail, but I like the fact that it's a Tune-O-Matic bridge and it's just not, you know, just some box with. I just like that part of it. It seems like it. Me playing mostly that would be easier for me to go over to them.
Yeah. And I especially like the Peavey Hardtail ones is because the saddle and the tailpiece are routed down into the body.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
So you got it, you know, makes for a nice neck joint because you're squishing everything together. The pickups are down into the body, not stick, you know. Hey, the base plate is even with the top of the body. That kind of crap drives me nuts.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
It's just
cool.
Ugly looking. So I'm always on the lookout for more PB Wolfgang bodies. But, yeah.
Oh, wow.
I mean, even though I would absolutely love to have a quilted maple purple, translucent purple PB Wolfgang hardtail, I'm just not really thrilled about spending $3,000 plus for one.
Yeah, I get that.
It's my hardtail.
I could buy a lot of hookers and blow with that.
You could support a lot of single moms like that.
Yes, I could support single moms if I didn't have to pay $3,000
for
a PB.
Out there churning butter like crazy.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Tax write-off. It's a tax write-off.
It's for business. Research. Come on, IRS. Yeah. You think they believe that? Yeah. Research purposes.
Just ask for a receipt.
Charity. It's charity. It is charity.
Can I get a receipt, please?
So Randy or Ryan, who got the Friedman Cowie? And will we see it on Sunday?
I think Ryan did, I think. I want to say Ryan got it, but I'm not 100% sure. Really cool. New guitar day, man.
You'll see it on Sunday.
Right on.
See you on Sunday. Cool.
Randy, okay. That didn't answer the question.
Who got it? Yeah, I guess we'll see you on Sunday. See you tomorrow. Nathan, you ready to play?
Yeah, sure. Why not?
All right. Let's do that. Let's see if you're ready. Let's get you soloed here, sir, and you can go ahead and jam on something. We'll be right back. Dude, that was awesome.
Nicely done.
Awesome, son.
I dig that delay that you got on there, Nathan.
Really cool.
A pretty bitchin' delay sound.
Thank you.
Can hear it bouncing back and forth.
Yeah. Yeah. Very awesome, man. Awesome job. Awesome job. And the people in the chat like it too, man. They saying you sounded awesome.
It's good.
Very cool. Mr. Biter, do you want to hit with another tune there? Or?
Yeah, but I want to talk about this this delay that you got here.
Oh, me? Oh,
yeah.
The Boss SDE-3000. Yeah,
get out that easy.
I forgot all about it. I'm sitting here listening to everybody else playing, and I'm like, what?
Let's hear what your thoughts are.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah. I'm sorry. Yeah, I was just, man. It all started when the last show we did here, and then Ryan and who else? R2 was on here, and Ryan and you, and you know everybody. About half the crew was over here as some special guest, and I was talking to Ryan about his setup, and then he said that I think him and a couple other people on his crew use, I think they have the EVH version of the Boss delay. And I wasn't really concerned about the wet, dry, wet thing. I mean, I did my research on it and I checked it out, but it's not going to serve me much with the setup I have, which isn't a really elaborate thing. I said, well, I would just like to have the unit. And I did a lot of checking videos out, research, whatever you want to call it. I was watching a lot of stuff. And I finally, I said, you know what? I'm going to get this thing. And I went looking on Reverb, and I found one. And it got here pretty quick. And I hooked it up. And at the very beginning, everything was kind of like just in the middle. The delay trails were like in the middle, like it would be with anything else, any kind of effects processor or a delay pedal or whatever. And I was like, no, okay. I said, I know you can make these trails do some different things, because people that did the reviews on YouTube were doing that. And I was like, all right, man, I bet you I watched probably, man, I don't know, a crap ton of videos trying to just see if anybody would say, here's what you do. You go here, here, and here, and you can save your setting, or you can pick how you want the thing to go. And yeah, you can probably look at a manual and all that. Who wants to do that when you should be able to look at a video and they can tell you in 10 seconds? But that wasn't my
Well,
look.
We're also men, so screw the instructions.
Yeah, exactly. So,
we're also old, so we can't read that fine print in them books.
Exactly, man. And I was like, okay, man, so... let's see, it got delivered one day last week, and it got here like 3:30, and I was like, dang, I gotta go to work at 4. I have to leave here about 4, a couple minutes after 4. And so I plugged it up real quick, you know, and just played a couple of chords, and I was like, man, I don't hear nothing special about it, you know, dang. So I had to leave, and that's when I was checking out all the videos later on that night. And and I came across this one video of this guy. He was a kind of a younger guy, and he said, I'm gonna go over a couple of points that I see all the other people, the videos they made, they didn't talk about. And I was like, well, is he going to say anything about it? Or, and his video was the one video I kept ignoring. It kept popping up in my, I was like, I don't know, because the thumbnail looked stupid, you know, the thumbnail looked weird, and I was like, I'm not looking at that. That guy don't know what he's talking about, you know. Turned out to be that was the video I needed to watch. But he brushed over very, very briefly about a couple of buttons to push, but he didn't go in depth. He just goes, you press this, press this, but I'm going to talk about something else. I went, oh my God, are you serious, man? So I came home from work. I got home at like 5:30, 5:45 that morning. Got here, and I said, I've got to see if this works. I've got to see if it works. So I just turned on the delay unit by itself. I didn't turn on nothing else. And I hit those buttons, and that's what I needed. You know, and I said, oh, there it is. That's how you can access that part and select panning mode or whatever, you know. And I said, okay, I got that. Now I got to hear what it sounds like. So then I turned everything on. I got the door closed in the music room. I put the headphones on. I grabbed one of the guitars off the wall. and I play with a backing track, and I get done, man. I get done playing, and I'm like, oh, that sounds incredible, man. I found out how to save the settings and everything, and so I didn't want to go to sleep, you know, because I was just so happy the way it sounded, right on. You know. But it's well worth the money if you're thinking about a Boss SDE 3000 delay unit. It's worth every penny, you know. And I was like, man,
cool.
Yeah, it was really cool. I really enjoyed it. It was I made a video and I sent it to Andrew the next morning. I said, listen to this, man, see what you think. And he said he liked it. So yeah, it was I was getting worried because I thought maybe something was wrong with the unit, because I wasn't getting that stereo delay effect. It was just, you know, like in the middle, and I was like, oh no, is that why this unit is used, because who had it before me sent it back or something. I was getting all nervous. But whoever had it, they didn't know how to dial into it.
Joe, don't ever turn that off, ever. Don't ever turn it off. Just
leave
it on
all the time. Don't turn it off. Yeah, it's actually on right now. But the funny thing is, the way I have my headphones plugged into the interface and I play something, you won't hear it. Well, you'll hear it, but to me, it doesn't do the stereo effect, and because the way I'm plugged in. But the effect going out to everybody else, they'll hear it. That's fine with me. I already know, because I didn't did test run after test run after test run after test run, you know. So Blue Mox, he says, Joe, what settings are you running now? Okay, that's kind of a broad question. Like what my setup, it's my setup, I get the main tone Blue Mox from my Head Rush Prime, and after the Head Rush Prime is the Boss SDE delay unit that I was just talking about. And then out of that delay unit, it's going in to my mixer, small little Yamaha mixer, $170 from Sweetwater. And then out of the mixer into inputs 1 and 2 of the interface. And of course, you know, I have my DAW activated. And I do have a couple of plugins activated on my DAW too, for Eventide Harmonizer that R2 R3 Lockinut introduced me to. Yeah.
Cool.
Let's see. R2 says I need to make a video. I do. I was going to make a video on how I access that part of that pedal and to save it. I have not did a deep dive on this pedal, so I'm not claiming to be an expert or nothing, because I know some people on YouTube, man, they get crazy, you know. And I can just show you what I know so far, you know. But I did have to download the manual to see how the video I saw, the guy, what buttons to push. Yes, that helped me immensely, but he didn't show you how to save anything. So I had to download the manual to learn how to save what I wanted, which is really easy. I just didn't know what to, you know, I didn't know what to push. Blue Monk says, okay, I'm just talking about the wet, dry, wet with the delay. Well, mine's just 100% wet, Blue Monk. It's not wet, dry, wet. It's just totally wet. So it's just stereo, really. It's not a wet, dry, wet. I don't have the EVH version, which I just got the regular stereo version. Yeah, it's a Eventide Rocks. Edwin says, "Yeah, I love it. I love the Eventide plugins. They help me out a lot." So, yeah, man, I'll let Jimmy play a song, and when Jimmy gets done, I'll play a song, and then we can hear everybody set up here. So,
all right,
Jimmy, cool. Are you cool with that? Is that all right with you, sir?
Yep. No, you've hurt my feelings, Joe.
Oh,
how dare you?
I'm sorry. Take it away, my man.
All right, here we go.
My toes aren't fat enough. I missed the switch. We'll be right back.
There you go. Dude, that was incredible.
That was bitching.
I love Corrosion of Conformity. God damn.
Nice.
Very cool, man. Very cool. All right. So, here's what this Blue Mox was asking about the sound here. That's what we got so far. So, let's see if we can play a song.
Nice.
That's it. That's a little bit of
Right on. Nicely done, Joe.
Let's do one more, right?
Very nice.
Yeah.
Nicely done, Joe.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, thank you. All right, who's next?
Next.
That was worth the price of the roadcaster right there. That the cricket button.
Okay. All right. Good stuff.
All righty.
Yeah. Nicely done, Joe.
Thank you, guys.
Sounded great.
Thank you so much. Yeah, man, it was fun.
That delay is just amazing. Yeah.
Oh, good. It comes through on that side. Good.
Yep.
All right. Cool, man. Very cool. Because, like I said, coming out of the interface, I just hear just regular. It's kind of weird how that is. So, yeah. Thank you, Edwin. And thank you, Randy. Thank you, man. Mr. John, thank you very much, man. Very kind. Thank you very much. Now I want to give everybody else a chance too, man. I don't want to hog it up like that. That's not cool.
Why not? It's your show, Joe.
Yeah, but that's not.
I don't want to hear me doing anything.
Right. Yeah, but that's not. Yeah, you know, that's not fair to everybody else. But yeah, man. Oh Lord, does anybody want to touch on anything else guitar related?
Yeah, I want to see that Steinberger.
Oh, okay. All right, hang on. Let's see here. Yeah, that's a new addition, man. It was. Yeah, go figure. Ain't that a shocker?
Delay, Steinberger. What else?
Yeah.
It's been 2 weeks.
Yeah. What are you waiting on? Hurry up! Yeah, man. It's
Oh, that woke Ryan up. Look at it. He's back.
Yeah. It's not what it's nothing like what Steinberg? He's got. He's got the original. This is a Steinberger Spirit Pro, I think. Let me present myself here. And but I will say when I was watching Ryan play his, and I was like, man, that just looks so cool. And of course I can't afford that model. There's no way. But so I just got one of the cheapos, man. But what's so weird is learning how to kind of get it set up. The guy, whoever had it, it's in mint shape, man, mint condition. Got it from Reverb. And the guy that had it before me, it wasn't tuned. It was nothing. And you could tell the strings had been on it for many, many years. And I had to watch a few videos on how to kind of get it where it worked for me. And I did. Now, the pickups are kind of, they're okay. They're not the best, but they're not the worst. And the bar that he sent is just the regular whammy bar, and it would not fit down into the cavity. And I was like, am I just doing something wrong? And it doesn't fit. So I took one of my Floyd Rose bars and put down in there, and there's a small little Allen screw in the back behind the bar, really, really small. And when you tighten that down, it keeps it perfect. And I was like, well, that works. So, you know, but that's right. R2, you're right. A travel guitar. I wanted something like this. So if we take a trip and I could take this with me as a little travel guitar, that's exactly right. It just feels weird. It just feels weird to play it because it's so small and there's no headstock. And I was playing it some last night and I kept going to the wrong place on the neck when I went to, you know, solo whatever. I was like, oh, I'm supposed to be down here. I mean, it just kept throwing me off. So just a little getting used to. But I played it for about an hour and a half last night after I got it set up. And I will say, man, I was shocked. It holds its tuning really well. I was really shocked at that. I didn't think it would do that. But it does. It does really good. I'm happy with it. You know, it's fun to play. The only thing is I gotta try to find out where to get the double ball ended strings. excuse me, for a decent price, because the ones I got, was it LaBella or something? and they were like $27 from Amazon for one pack. And I was like, God, Timu, I don't want to mess with them. But yeah, man, took the mold strings off. It's really easy to string up once you understand what to do, and it's really simple, and it stays in tune, and yeah, I had fun with it. You know, it's the gig bag's really small, and it's I like it. I like it.
Randy's saying, yeah, check the strings at Headless USA.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, Randy. Thank you. Thank you so much for that, Randy. Yeah, appreciate that.
Yeah,
it'd
be a sweet little travel guitar on there. Is that a floating bridge, or is it just dive only?
It's you can have it both, according to what I saw. You can have it where it's just floating or non-floating. You can have it either way.
Right on.
I got it set for non-floating, but it's still kind of stiff. But it don't bother me. I don't care. I'm cool with it. But thank you, R2. Thanks, man. Joe and R2 Nam trip. Oh my goodness. Let's see. Jamie H2011. Hey man, how are you? Nice to see you. Let's see. Ryan, hey man, he says Gibson should sell them too. Cheaper for regular ball in.
Yeah.
So,
of course, you know.
But yeah, I will definitely look into that, Randy. Thank you for telling me that, because I was like, man, I can't see.
Yeah, you'd think that the company that owns, you know, the Steinberger name would, you know, we'll sell the shit too. No, fuck.
I know, man. But yeah, shoot, man.
They're still around, right?
Steinberger.
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, they're still around. Yeah, I'll look these guitars up. I think I saw it on Musician's Friend. Was it that? And I think brand new, those go for like $450, $460. And that guy had it. That guy had that one on for sale for like $330. And I lowballed it and said $275. He took it. I didn't think he would. I didn't think he would.
Well. It's definitely not a seller's market anymore.
Right.
It's a buyer's market. There's a lot of stuff hanging around.
He took a loss, man. I've been down that road with Reverb. I've sold guitars. Man, I didn't hardly make nothing. Reverb hit me with some fees and extra this, extra that, because I got on their S list, let's just say. And they kind of made me pay for that more than once. Ryan says, I'm just saying they do sell them on Gibson's website. Oh, nice, man. Thank you. I'll definitely check that out.
Cool. Awesome. Lawyer up before you buy anything. You know Gibson.
Uh-oh.
Do they own double balls?
Uh-oh.
I don't know, but apparently Mr. Deshane thinks I got three balls now. I used to, but I sat on one and exploded, so I'm back to two.
He had four, but he knocked the one off his mic earlier today.
Oh, that's great. That's awesome. Y'all are so funny. Well, we have hit our 2-hour mark, gentlemen. Let me go around the room here and see if there's anything else anybody wants to add. Ryan says that's $8 on Sweetwater. Are you serious?
That's not a bad price.
Wow. I'm going to be jumping on there in a minute. Because I just got the one set that's on there. I don't have a backup set. So, yeah. Thank you, Ryan.
Might as well get a guitar while you're on there.
No. We can't. Come on, man.
Hey. Free shipping.
You want new, one of them new moderns with the fancy neck keel and the Floyd.
Yeah. I mean, you got to get it. You got to get American, the free shipping.
Get you the American Ultra Lux Stratocaster.
Oh my goodness. There you go. Set up by Marshall. Hey man, how are you doing, sir? I hope you're doing good, man. Thank you for joining. Thank you. We're getting ready to wrap up, but hey, thank you for being here. Thank you so much. All right, let's go around the room here. Mr. Biter, anything you want to touch on that we didn't maybe talk about, or anything else, or something that's any goings on that you want to talk to promote or anything?
No. I don't promote my own channel. I'm just a whore, remember?
Oh, that's great. All right, let's go over to Mr. Knox.
Practice the guitar. Practice. Play.
That's right.
Play. There play the goddamn guitar.
That's right. Have fun and play, man. That's fun. Have a good time and play. All right. R2 said he's going to buy a headless guitar now. Oh, my goodness.
Starting the thing.
I see you, Marshall. Man, thank you for popping in, man. R2 says he's serious. He's on Guitar Center website right now. Oh, boy.
Oh
boy. What is going on? Let's go on to Mr. Knox.
Strandberg. Come on.
Buy it from there, R2.
Oh, you know what? Before we wrap up, I got one thing, man. I got one thing I need to share, and then we'll leave. We'll leave after that. Ryan says,
screw the rest of y'all.
Ryan, what have I done? No, nah, dude, it was a good thing. R2 says, after watching Randy and Joe, I need one. Uh-oh. Mm. You know what? I meant to touch on this earlier, and I'm sorry. I totally forgot. But I got to meet Andrew a couple weeks ago. What was it? A couple of weeks? 2 weeks ago? 1 week ago?
It was 2 weeks ago.
I got to meet Andrew.
Last show, yeah.
Yeah, that's right. And Andrew was in the area, and we communicated, and he said, hey, can we meet up? And I was like, sure, man. I was like, can you meet me where I deliver? Because it's just going to, you know, I'll drive a rig, and it just works out better that way. He's like, yeah. So he did. He met me one night, and I made a video of our meetup. Now, it's not guitar-related or nothing like that because, you know, it's at my place of where I deliver. So there's not a lot going on there. But I did get to meet Andrew, and he was super cool, man. We got to talk and have some laughs. We talked for about, I don't know, 45 minutes or so. And so I'm going to, let's see, make sure I got the audio on here. And let's see if I can share this. Will it let me? Okay. Let's see if we can share this. And let's make it full screen first. All right. There we go. All right, so here we go. This is meeting up with Andrew Knox, everybody. So enjoy. Hey, everybody. Joe for the Joe Wins Project. You can see I'm back at work now. I'm back on the workhorse again. But look who came to visit, man. Andrew Knox.
Hey, everybody.
What's up, man?
How y'all doing?
He just happened to be in town. They're on vacation, and he just, what did you say, 6 minutes?
Yeah,
down
right
the street.
Over there, Dirty Myrtle.
He's like, hey, can I meet you? I was like, yeah, that's awesome. So you recognize Andrew from the show. He's on the panel when he can make it. And, man, it's so nice to meet you, man, in person.
It's
so cool,
buddy.
Man.
Halftime.
Hashtag halftime. That's right. That's his handle. So we've been chatting for about 20 minutes, just, you know, talking. And I didn't want to be filming when he pulled up and him not agree to it, you know, so. But I was going to walk him around here and just tell him about what it is I do down here. Y'all already know that. If y'all watch the channel, you know that. So I'm going to show this to him real quick.
All right.
So right here, this, so you'll know, every truck represents like maybe two or three routes or whatever they cover.
Okay.
All right. So you got, usually I think there's six. One, two, three, four. Well, now there's five. And the one at the end, yeah, that's, I think they use that for ice cream sometimes, which is weird because we don't do ice cream no more. So I don't know, maybe they're doing milk on the rental right there. But see, back in the day, man, we had, when I would come here to deliver, you had up to like 12 route trucks in this spot. Now you only got not even half that.
Wow.
So it makes me nervous, man, because I'm like, am I gonna have a job?
Oh, you short time.
See in the distance, you can barely see the Ferris wheel.
Yeah, so you can see that from our hotel on the other side.
Oh, okay.
So we actually can see that out of our window.
Ah, okay, that's nice, man.
Yeah.
That's nice. So how long y'all down here for?
We go back Tuesday.
Oh.
I go back to work Wednesday.
Oh, okay.
So.
Yeah, I was off last week. It was nice, man, having a whole week off.
Yep, we saw that.
We
went and got the Purple Jackson.
Yeah. Action Jackson, man. 74? Yeah. 74. Oh, my God. Yeah, man. I So do you remember watching the when I do the little trucker episodes down here and all this? He said it didn't look like he would imagine.
Like in the videos, to me, it looks like you're just the pet thing is here and that's it. Like there's stuff across the street. Yeah. All this is lit up. It just looks dark usually.
It usually is. It and they actually put a couple of lights in here recently, so it was a lot darker. Thank God. So I'd be down
here.
Is that
the Pizza Hut over there? Is that the distribution thing?
Yeah, I think that's just a home office. Yeah, it's you can't see it, but it says Pizza Hut on the building right there for people who are watching, and it's been there forever. You remember me telling the story when I was out here and the crazy guy was out here running around? Right here, yeah. So I have to pull out onto this street. They just recently paved this like within the past few weeks. It was a rough street and they just, thank God it's paved, but I had to pull out up here out of the gate and park because I had to shut the gate back here behind us. So I pull up here and there's this guy. He just appeared out of nowhere and he starts running back and forth and running down here. And that dude,
South Carolina's finest.
That dude was crazy, man. He was hopped up on something. So I had to get out of the truck and go close the gate. And he was standing right in front of my truck. So I have a spare key in my pocket. So I locked the door and he was doing weird stuff. So when I got back in my truck.
Around your truck?
Yeah, he was standing right in front of my truck. And then, and of course, you can see there's nobody out here in the middle of the night. You're kind of on your own, right? So he was standing right there. And when I got back in the truck, I was watching him. He come beside the truck and he stopped. And I looked and then he just started running. He just started running straight down there. He just took off like, you know, an Olympic athlete.
Just say no, kids.
Yeah, and this guy, he had like a black hoodie on and he had it over his head and blue jeans. And I was like, this guy's out to lunch. So, but you know, I had something on me just in case, you know, but you know, I was like, if this guy, you know, if something's going to happen, it's going to happen now. But he ended up running down the street. Like he was wigged out.
Found what he was looking for.
So, man. So if you remember, Andrew, if you watched the videos, I know you did.
Here it comes.
Do you know what that entrance is right there? See if you remember. You see the lights? The green lights?
Oh, that's the clerk.
Y'all crazy bitch, but you fuck so good, I'm on top of it.
This is the back entrance of the damn strip club. That's how close support we are, or I am, to this facility.
Too much on a Sunday. I don't think they do.
I mean, well, they're working, but it's just, they're just not, you know, it's funny because I've seen. This place was another business, another adult club. And then when you know, the big thing happened where everything was shut down, it completely shut down. And whoever owned it sold it. And these new guys, you could tell they put some money into it. They redid a lot of stuff and put lights on it. And so when I'm out here dropping my trailer, you can hear that. You can hear that stuff in there. So you see, you can hear it. You can hear it a little bit. Yeah, they're out there. Yeah, I don't walk it. When they were completely down, and that, you know, not in service, I would come and walk the parking lot and just turn around and come back just to get some exercise, you know. Because we're right there, where the, you know, the facility is for, you know, dropping our freight off, and then you're just a stone's throw away from
the partay.
from the park. And what's weird, man, is the guy that used to do this run before I got it, he was an older guy and he always looked kind of nasty and stuff. I think he always went over there. Let's go on this side. I think he always went over there on his 30 minute break.
Sam, we noticed that you were at the ranch for two hours. What are you doing down there?
Exactly. Well, that was before we had computers. We got computers in the truck now. I'm on my break, so I'm safe. But we didn't have computers then. So I think he'd come down here because he would bring load number one. I'd bring load number two. And I'd leave like, you know, an hour or so after he done left. I'd get down and he'd still be down here. And I'm like, what the hell is he still doing here? And I said, oh, I know what he's doing. He's filling them dollar bills up over there. But
he's going to make it rain.
He was a big old fat nasty son of a gun, boy. I was like, damn.
A lot to make it rain, man.
But anyway, I just thought that was funny. But he don't work here no more, so it don't matter. So, But yeah, this is it, man. This is a small little hole in the wall, but it's a, you know, small facility, but it's how I make my bread and butter.
I hear you.
You know,
it's cool, man. Like, I mean, you just wouldn't know it was back here because everything's up there.
Yeah,
and
it's...
I mean, you know, that, like, even in a town like this, unless it's going on, you know, there's a lot of things that have to keep it running.
And the thing that gets me is this location is just on the borderline of being in the sketchy town.
Yeah.
This just on the border. You kind of are, but you kind of not.
You can jump in and out of that here pretty quick.
Easy, right here in this area. Easy. And it's just... I don't know, man. It's just, you know, when you're down here, you just always just, you know, what they say, keep eyes in the back of your head, so to speak. Just keep looking around just to be on the safe side. But yeah, but it's all right, man. I wish we was at Guitar Center or something.
Yeah.
I hate that it's like this, but, you know, what can you do, man?
But next time we'll meet at Guitar Center, I can tell you all the secrets.
That way. Oh, yeah, that's what I want to know. Hell yeah, that's
you
awesome.
This cat over here, he ain't doing
Yeah, man, that's great. But all right, guys, that's it for this video. I just wanted to introduce you to Andrew. I'm so glad to meet you, man. Finally,
good to meet you too.
That's awesome. So thank y'all for watching, and take care of yourself. Peace. Stay cool on your stool. We'll see you later.
All right, man.
Very cool.
That's wild. Check out Andrew, man. That was so cool to be able to meet him.
That's wild.
That was awesome.
See, though, Jimmy's shirt, and now that, it went full circle.
Yes.
Yeah, single tied it all together.
Yeah, I didn't know you were that close to it.
All of that.
Strip club there. It's like freaking walking out there. You might get shanked by a disgruntled stripper.
Oh, man.
I knew I should have played cherry pie. You will.
Yeah, it's just that place has always been there, and it's just you're just kind of on the just the that's the rear parking lot entrance is what that is. So it's just a
pun intended.
I don't know. It's just, you know, it's weird, crazy stuff. But anyway, all right. We asked Jimmy. He said, "Keep playing guitar." Let's go to Mr. Knox now. Anything you want to touch on, sir? Any final words?
Dollar bills in the club. That's all I got.
Okay.
Oh, I woke up my cat. Look, he's mad. He's pissed. He's
all. Uh-oh.
Oof.
Uh-oh. Fuck, Daddy. What the fuck?
What about you, Mr. Larry?
I got a lot going on, but I don't know. Okay. It's all good. I need more gear.
More gear. Uh-oh. Larry's going to be buying some stuff tonight. All right. Let's move over to Nathan. Nathan, any final words, man? Anything that you want to touch on that maybe we didn't?
Just everybody have a nice, good, positive weekend.
That sounds great.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I like that. We'll close on that positive vibe right there. How about
Absolutely.
That? I like that. That's awesome. Thank you, everybody, who has taken the time to check out the show, man. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. If you're a returning viewer, thank you very much. I appreciate it very, very, very much. Let me make sure I let everybody on the panel be on camera there. And, all right, with that being said, we will see you in 2 weeks for another episode of Talking Guitars and More. Thank you to everybody again who was on here. And thank you to those in the chat who participated. If you watch on the replay, give us a thumbs up on the way out if you can. You know, we really appreciate it. Until next time, my name's Joe for Joe Wicks Project TV. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye. All right.
She came in and sat down right in front of me. She picked up the glass of wine as I took.